You know, let's just kick it. You know what I'm saying? Busy as hell around here. Athens, Georgia. Picked Marty up a nice cheeseburger. Fries, two big ass fries. I mean, these motherfuckers are big, man. Yeah, let's go, let's kick it. You know what I'm saying? Let's get out of this maze, this concrete jungle. I'm gonna go a different little way today. Because I want to slide down a different way. Right. Yeah, this is where it's at. Epps Park Road, Parkway, I think they call it. Just like people everywhere, man. This is shitty parking design, though. It's too narrow. If you got a pickup here, it's even worse. Yeah, I need to go around doing parking consulting. That's why you see the pickups backed in. It's a fucking nightmare. I'm saying, people, man, no, I'm saying, I need to get out of this place, man. Is anybody getting out of here? Does anybody really care? Go ahead, babe. Good looking blonde. Oh, yeah, man. Epps Parkway. I like going the scenic route, personally. Which I will do. Yield, I'm gonna beat this one. Barely. Yeah, they're gonna try and give me a ticket, ain't happening. Beautiful sunny day, 43 degrees, dry as a bone. We're gonna get warm weather this week, 70s. And lots of rain, I love it. Get my camera batteries all charged. Just the soft, subtle sound of the rain banging on the metal roof. Oh yeah, just make me like doze off. Oh yeah, I'm sleepy, man. Why am I sleepy? Because it should be dozing. There's a cop down there. Look, he's got his blinkers on. I hope he didn't get me on a camera or something. Motherfucker. Oh, church. Church services here. Yep. I can't believe the church, you know, it's big down here. Churches everywhere. You just be kicking it, know what I'm saying? Yeah, bury that motherfucker. I'm gonna do some sunsets. Four-wheel high, that's what I'm going to put it in. About a book on writing, Why Writers Write. You know, I lived in Ann Arbor for a long time. I wasn't really into reading like I am now. Nicholas Del Banco. Man, talk about a CV. God damn. He produced two good daughters, too. I mean, this guy be tripping and shit, you know what I'm saying? Now, I could go down Timothy, but I don't feel like going that way, really. Just don't. Why? I can't quite explain it adequately. I think, well, I do know why. I don't want to go through Watkinsville, go straight south, and then go east, even though GPS claims it's 2 miles shorter. I think they're full of shit. There's sometimes when you have to just override technology. You have to look back at past experience and say to yourself, what a bunch of bullshit. And then just fly like an eagle when I'm free. Fly like an eagle. I know it's all gonna come to me. Teresa Hall, Kentucky. Janice. They're always keeping track of my stuff for me. Let me know what's good and what isn't. Which I'm eternally appreciative. I think, oh, Teresa missed this one. Where are you, girl? Because I want to fly. I hope you made it to Mark Kropka's thing last night. There's a girl out there running. She's in the dating years. Of course, she wants to stay slim. Fast forward 40 years, won't be able to get her off the couch. Every 2 years, gets bigger jeans. Why? The pursuit is over. Produced kids, of her life, and that's already fizzled out. They're separated. And she says, fuck running. I think I'll eat a box of chocolates. This is life. She no longer buys fashion magazines, but looks for all-you-can-eat buffets. Her life has changed. Her husband got fat, too. They'd have intercourse, but they, neither one wanted to die of massive heart attacks. It's called the golden years. Sunny days like this because I want to catch the sundown as I go home. Sundown, Gordon Lightfoot. And I kind of like going through campus. Today's youth. There's a bag lady, poor girl. Or is that a bag guy? That's a bag guy. College towns get premium money for their real estate. All of them. It's just interesting to me how they morph into all similar design. From the way they stack the bagels in the case to the homes to the different changes in architecture, old and new, to preserving the past. I guess it's some these people have graduates of historical renovation. They kind of hang around. They get a lot of free help while they're going to school to like do projects, and it's expensive to keep buildings historically relevant. Not, you know, put some brand new Home Depot Hardy board on them. Maybe that's the advantage they have, a captive audience. Always looking for extra credit, experiences they've had, that kind of thing. $20 at that Five Faces, which is fine. But that's, I don't know how they stay in business. I really don't. It's a mystery to me. That McAllister's Deli, I went there one time. I didn't think it was that great. can't beat a good Jewish deli. Cook out, it can take him or leave him. He's got a nice tray. I think he's got one of those load-bearing digital apparatuses on his trailer hitch that let you know how much tongue weight you have. Kind of cool. The truth of the matter is, though, if you've even hauled stuff a little while and you have the right equipment, you can get away with murder on tongue weight. You want the weight on the tongue and not on the tail if you're going to overload it. It'll turn into the tail wagging the dog. Believe it or not, when it gets squirrely like that, it gets worse. You're supposed to hit the gas. That takes some big balls. The tail's wagging the dog and you're freaking out. You don't want to wreck, and then you got to hit the gas too. You better have some big nuts for that. Everybody wants to hit the brake. Same thing when they hit ice. First thing you want to do is hit that brake. You want to slow down. Your brain, your eyes are interpreting the signal to your brain. Slow. When really you shouldn't be touching the brake. Takes big balls once again. So what you can take away from this is if you're going to get in situations where things aren't looking good, particularly in vehicles, trailers, you better have big balls when the shit hits the fan. Because if you don't, you're going to exacerbate what's happening. This is where I got my great bagel today. Ideal Bagel Company. It's good, too. We close at 2 o'clock. Right there. Couple cars in the lot, cleaning up. Starlight, I don't know what that is. This is University of Georgia campus. Always busy. Football weekends were like crazy. A lot of new construction. Apartments. campus. Just kicking it. Cameras everywhere. I think that's a red light camera up there on the top left, that little skinny one. Christmas party and shit, you know what I'm saying? $2.60 for gas, that's good. They rip you off on diesel up here, though. I mean, they put it to your ass. I mean, they whoop that ass. They whoop that ass. I mean, whoop that ass. I mean, whoop that ass. An eagle. Might go to Florida tomorrow. A couple days, get a couple of bikini babies. Just sit out and drink beer. Look out on the horizon. It's like, what up and shit, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I want to fly like an eagle. When I'm free, I want to get crazy. I want to be super happy. That's how I change the lyrics. Fly, fly, fly like an eagle. Fly like an eagle. I'm gonna be crazy. Fly like a baby. I'm gonna be all free. I wanna do it. That was a fun chat on Mark Kropka Pirate Radio last night. I mean, it really was, man. We just smiled. Conversation about Marcia from Cincinnati, Ohio. And party with Marcia next time I go through there. I'm gonna party all night. I thought there were two Marcias for a little bit last night. There were only one. I thought the other one had an avatar, but it was the same one. Dragon's Milk. Just doing stupid shit. Cop pulls you over. He said, "Dude, you know I'm pulling you over." It's like, God damn, I had three Dragon's Milk. Your guess is as good as mine. It's like, well, I'm not guessing. I know why I pulled you over. You crossed the yellow line. It's like, look, man, this vehicle is not a track. It's not a train. You know, I'm looking at switching radio stations. I got a GoPro. I'm talking to my YouTube people. I got a lot of shit going on. Just because some rubber went across and painted strip in the road, I'm getting, like, pulled over for this? Yeah, you had anything to drink? Yeah, I did. I had a latte, skim milk. Today I tried almond milk. No, I said, that's not what I'm talking about. If you had any alcohol? It's like, no. I'm going to have some tonight, though. He said, that doesn't matter either. He said, he under the influence of any marijuana, drugs, prescription? No. Nope. Nothing. He said, I took a Viagra 2 nights ago. Doesn't matter. Would you mind doing a sobriety test? Like, oh god, man, you be blowing that thing. Breathalyzer. Just blow as hard as you can. generic place to get a ticket around here. These motherfuckers are everywhere. He's hiding in the weeds. He's trying to bust your ass. He was crazy. He got caught putting a roofie in a girl's drink and convicted of it. Another preacher down the drain. Jeez, that just is so foreign to me. I mean, who'd want sex with people doing that? You gotta be one fucked up motherfucker. Last time I got nailed down there around Statesboro, one of those fucking places, Waynesboro, coming back from my divorce, I was talking to Rita, and all of a sudden, as soon as I saw those parking lights come on, I knew I was fucked. It was simultaneous. All of a sudden, a dark, desolate area in a rural environment turned into a photo shoot. It's like, motherfucker, man. I just pulled right the fuck over. Turn my dome light on, put my hands out the side. Real heavy guy, maybe 5'3", 300 pounds. He said, "You're cool." I thought, "Oh, great, I don't have the world's biggest super prick." He said, "Sir, the reason I pulled you over is you've been doing 74 and a 55. It's like, do you want me to show you my radar calibrator?" It's like, nah, fuck it. Nah, it's working, man. As soon as those lights came on, I looked down, 74. What's the chances of both our things not working? I said, "You know what? I'm not one of these, like, right to traverse these highways as a sovereign citizen. You guys got a hard job. Just give me a fucking ticket, man. Appreciate you out here doing your job. Just got it stuck up my ass in a divorce with some fucking cherry on the top." I said, "I appreciate it if I can get some break or take a fucking class online or something. But if I don't, I got it coming to me. Far away." He said, "Well, let's just check this out, sir." Went back to his car. Came back and said, "I'm not giving you a ticket." I said, "You're kidding me." He said, "Nope. You had a rough day today." I said, "Oh, that's great. Thank you." And he warned me about another cop 15 miles up the road. He said, "Now, son, they're going to be sitting there. And he ain't going to be this way." Okay. Sure enough, there he was, sitting between two bushes. And I said, "No shit." But I looked at that speedometer. Right where it should be, 50 or some shit like that. Oglethorpe County High School. Oh yeah, I said, "Let's kick it." You know what I'm saying? Discount store. It's gonna get a little affordable. 41, not bad today. I'm debating to go to Florida or not. Because I think you're crazy. I'm crazy too. Yeah, man. Lexington, you better go slow through here. I ain't fucking around. I'm gonna go down 77 right here. Different way. looking for wood thieves. Bean stealers. Kick it. You know what I'm saying? I'm debating whether I want to go to Gatlinburg, downtown Atlanta, or Florida for a couple.